A happy Sunday to all of you, my dear friends. The cries of the poor pierces the clouds, says the first reading today from the book of Sirach. Yesterday, someone sent me a small clip of the Holy Father Pope Francis walking in his characteristic style and smile with a small umbrella. It was drizzling and he was carrying his own umbrella. A few days back, perhaps, the world was surprised that he was carrying his own briefcase with no one to help him, with no one to come after him. That's the mark of a humble man. Our Holy Father is a very humble man. Today's Sunday speaks about humility and simplicity. The cries of the poor pierces the clouds. The responsorial psalm tells us, this poor man called, and the Lord heard him. The Lord hears the cries of the humble. It's beautiful to see God bending towards the poor, the humble, the marginalized. We have in the Gospel these two characters, a proud man, a Pharisee, who proclaims all that he has done to the Lord as if God doesn't know it. And he takes pride in saying, I am not like the other man there, who is standing behind and he is a good for nothing. And on the other hand, the publican is a sign of a sinner in the Bible, one who collects, one who defrauds. But then this man does not consider himself worthy enough even to come inside the synagogue, the temple. He stands outside and says, Lord, have mercy on me. This is the cry of the humble. Today's readings are very specially meant for all of us, because the Lord accepts the humble man. What's special about humility or the humble man? I would say three characteristics. First of all, a humble man acknowledges that he is nothing. All that he has is because of someone else who has given him, someone else who has favored him, and therefore the credit goes to someone else. But secondly, a humble man is always thanking, praising, because the little things that he gets, he praises. A proud man, first of all, he's so filled with his ego. He not only does not acknowledge the others, he has no time to thank and bless the others. And thirdly, a humble man trusts in God. That's more important, that I am what I am. I have what I have is not because of myself, but God has favored me. My dear brothers and sisters, we are in the extraordinary missionary month. And the gospel proclamation is out of humility. This is not our gospel, it's the gospel of the Lord, good news of the Lord which I give to the others. And imagine there's nothing in me that I can give. I can share only my humility, my unworthiness, but God has done great things to me. Like Mother Mary, she proclaims constantly that God has done great things to me. And that's the proclamation, that's the message of love, that's the message of the extraordinary missionary month. You know, St. Paul in the second reading today says that I was desperate, I was desolate, I was abandoned, but then I trusted in the Lord and God took me closer. And that's the message of the missionary month. It's not because of me, it's not because of what I'm saying, perhaps what I'm doing, but it's God who is projected in all that I do, in all that I say, and God's love is proclaimed to everybody. That's the message of the extraordinary missionary month. And I'm sure In most of your churches, you celebrate also the what's called the Mission Sunday. We make the collections, we have the raffles, the fetes, all this in order that we can help in some way the missions and the missionaries. But more important, that you are a part of the mission and you are a missionary yourself. God bless you. Pray for me very specially.